Fellowcraft, or Second Degree. I shall omit the ceremonies incident to opening a lodge of Fellowcrafts, as they are very similar to those employed in opening the First Degree, and will be explained hereafter more clearly to the reader. 5 are required by Masonic law to make a legal lodge of Fellowcrafts, viz. Worshipful Master, Senior and Junior Wardens, Senior and Junior Deacons. Yet 7, besides the tiller, generally officiate, and take their seats as in the Entered Apprentice Degree. We will suppose the lodge to be opened on the Fellowcraft Degree, and Mr. Gabb, who has previously taken the degree of Entered Apprentice, and been elected to that of Fellowcraft, is in the ante-room in waiting. The Master, being aware of this fact, will say, Worshipful Master, Brother Junior Deacon, you will take with you the necessary assistance and repair to the ante-room, where there is a candidate in waiting for the second degree in Masonry. And when you have him prepared, make it known by the usual sign. The Junior Deacon, with the 2 stewards accompanying him, steps to the center of the lodge, makes the due regard and signs of a Fellowcraft, and passes out of the lodge into the ante-room. Junior Deacon. Well, Brother Gabb, you will have to be prepared for this degree as all have been before you. You, of course, can have no serious objection? Brother Gabb. I have not. Junior Deacon. Then you will take off your boots, coat, pants, vest, necktie, and collar. And here is a pair of drawers, unless you have a pair of your own. Now you will slip your right arm out of your shirt sleeve, and put it through the bosom of your shirt, that your right arm and breast may be naked. The deacon here ties a hoodwink, or handkerchief, over both eyes. In the time of Morgan, it was the usage to cover only one eye. The junior deacon then ties a rope, by Masons called a cable toe, twice around his arm. Formerly, the rope was put twice round the candidate's neck. Some lodges follow the old custom now, but this is rather a rare thing. The reader will, however, do well to recollect these hints, as they are particular points. The right foot and knee of the candidate are made bare by rolling up the drawers, and a slipper should be put on his left foot. This being accomplished, the candidate is duly and truly prepared. The deacon now takes the candidate by the arm, and leads him forward to the door of the lodge. And upon arriving there he gives 3 raps, when the senior deacon, who has taken his station on the inside door of the lodge, reports to the master as follows. Senior Deacon. Worshipful Master, making the signs of a Fellowcraft, there is an alarm at the inner door of our lodge. Worshipful Master. You will attend to the alarm, and ascertain the cause. The deacon gives 3 raps, which are responded to by the junior deacon, and answered to by 1 rap from the senior deacon inside, who opens the door, and says, Senior Deacon. Who comes here? Junior Deacon. Conductor. Brother Gabb, who has been regularly initiated as Entered Apprentice, and now wishes to receive more light in Masonry by being passed to the degree of Fellowcraft. Senior Deacon. Turning to Candidate. Brother Gabb, is it of your own free will and accord? Candidate. It is. Senior Deacon. Brother Junior Deacon, is he duly and truly prepared, worthy and well qualified? Junior Deacon. He is. Senior Deacon. Has he made suitable proficiency in the preceding degree? Junior Deacon. He has. Senior Deacon. And properly vouched for? Junior Deacon. He is. Senior Deacon. Who vouches for him? Junior Deacon. A brother. Senior Deacon. By what further right, or benefit, does he expect to gain admission? Junior Deacon. By the benefit of a pass. Senior Deacon. Has he that pass? Junior Deacon. He has it not, but I have it for him. Senior Deacon. Advance, and give me the pass. Some say, advance the pass. Junior Deacon whispers in the senior deacon's ear the password, Shibboleth. Senior Deacon. The pass is right. You will wait with patience until the worshipful master is informed of your request, and his answer returned. The senior deacon then closes the door, and repairs to the center of the lodge, before the worshipful master in the east, and sounds his rod twice on the floor, which is responded to by the master with his gavel, when the same interrogations and answers are repeated by the master and deacon as at the door. The master then says, Worshipful Master. Let him enter, in the name of the Lord, and be received in due form. The senior deacon then takes the square from the altar, and, Repairing to the door, he opens it, and says, "Senior Deacon, let him enter in the name of the Lord, and be received in due form." The junior deacon advances through the door, followed by the two stewards, when the senior deacon stops them by placing the angle of the square against the candidate's right breast. Senior Deacon. Pressing square against candidate's breast. Brother Gab, on entering this lodge the first time you were received on the points of the compass, I now receive you on the angle of the square, which is to teach you that the square of virtue should be the rule and guide of your conscience in all future transactions with mankind. The senior deacon now takes the candidate by the right arm, followed by the stewards, and conducts him twice around the lodge, counting from the junior warden's station in the south, during which time the master reads the following passage of scripture. Thus he showed me, and behold, the Lord stood upon a wall made by a plumb line, with a plumb line in his hand. And the Lord said unto me, Amos, what seest thou? And I said, A plumb line. Then said the Lord, Behold, I will set a plumb line in the midst of my people Israel. I will not again pass by them any more. Amos 7, 7 and 8. While going around the lodge, as the conductor and candidate pass the officers' stations in the south, west, and east, they, the officers, sound the gavel as follows, the first time going round, one rap each. The second time, two raps each. By the time the master has finished reading the above passage of scripture, the candidate and conductor have passed around the room twice, and arrive at the junior warden's station in the south. Junior warden. Opening parenthesis giving two raps, which are responded to by the deacon. Who comes here? Senior deacon. Conductor. Brother Gab, who has been regularly initiated apprentice, and now wishes to receive more light in masonry, by being passed to the degree of Fellowcraft. Junior warden. Turning to candidate. Brother Gab, is it of your own free will and accord? Candidate. It is. Junior warden. Brother senior deacon, is he duly and truly prepared, worthy, and well qualified? Senior deacon. He is. Junior warden. Has he made suitable proficiency in the preceding degree? Senior deacon. He has. Junior warden. And properly vouched for? Senior deacon. He is. Junior warden. Who vouches for him? Senior deacon. A brother. Junior warden. By what further right, or benefit does he expect to gain admission? Senior deacon. By the benefit of the pass. Junior warden. Has he that pass? Senior deacon. He has it not, but I have it for him. Junior warden. Advance, and give me the pass. Senior deacon advances, and whispers in the junior warden's ear, Shibboleth. Junior warden. The pass is right. I will suffer you to pass on to the senior warden's station in the west. Senior warden. Who comes here? Senior deacon. Brother Gab, who has been regularly initiated apprentice, and now wishes to receive more light in masonry, by being passed to the degree of Fellowcraft. Senior warden. Turning to candidate. Brother Gab, is it of your own free will and accord? Candidate. It is, etc., and etc. Precisely the same questions and answers transpire as at the junior warden's station and at the door, and the candidate and conductor are permitted by the warden to pass to the worshipful master's station in the east. Worshipful master. Who comes here? Senior deacon. For candidate. Brother Gab, who has been regularly initiated apprentice, and now wishes to receive more light in masonry, by being passed to the degree of Fellowcraft. Worshipful master. Turning to candidate. Brother Gab, is it of your own free will and accord? Brother Gab. It is. Worshipful master. Brother senior deacon. The master speaking in a very deep tone of voice. Is he duly and truly prepared, worthy, and well qualified? Senior deacon. He is. Worshipful master. Has he made suitable proficiency in the preceding degree? Senior deacon. He has. Worshipful master. And properly vouched for? Senior deacon. He is. Worshipful master. Who vouches for him? Senior deacon. A brother. Worshipful master. By what further right or benefit does he expect to gain admission? Senior deacon. By the benefit of the pass. Worshipful master. Has he that pass? Senior deacon. He has it not. But I have it for him. Worshipful Master. Advance and give me the pass. Senior Deacon advances and whispers in the Master's ear, Shibboleth. Worshipful Master. The pass is right. From whence came you, and whither are you travelling? Senior Deacon. From the west, travelling toward the east. Worshipful Master. Why leave you the west, and travel toward the east? Senior Deacon. In search of more light. Worshipful Master. Since that appears to be the object of the candidate's search, it is my orders that he be reconducted to the senior warden in the west, who will teach him how to approach the east, by two upright regular steps, his feet forming an angle of a square, his body erect at the altar before the worshipful master in the east. Senior Deacon conducts the candidate back to the senior warden in the west, and says, Senior Deacon. Brother Senior Warden, it is the orders of the worshipful master that you teach this candidate to approach the east, by two upright regular steps, his feet forming an angle of a square, his body erect at the altar before the worshipful master in the east. Senior Warden leaves his seat, and, approaching the candidate, he leads him toward the altar, and within two steps of it, and says, Brother, you will first step off one full step with your left foot, bringing the heel of your right in the hollow of your left foot. Now you will step off with your right foot, bringing the heel of your left in the hollow of your right. The candidate is now within kneeling distance of the altar, and the senior warden makes the following report to the master, Worshipful Master, the candidate is now in order, and awaits your further will and pleasure. Worshipful Master. Brother Senior Warden, you will place him in due form for taking upon himself the solemn oath or obligation of a fellow craft. The senior warden, with the assistance of the senior deacon, now causes the candidate to kneel on his naked right knee, before the altar, making his left knee form a square. His left arm, as far as the elbow, should be held in a horizontal position, and the rest of the arm in a vertical position, forming another square. His arm supported by the square, held under his elbow, and his right hand resting on the open Bible. Worshipful Master. Brother Gab, you are kneeling for the second time at the sacred altar of Masonry, to take upon yourself the solemn oath or obligation of a fellow craft. And I take pleasure, as master of this lodge, to say to you, as on a former occasion, there is nothing in this oath that will interfere with the duty that you owe to your God, your family, country, neighbor, or self. Are you willing to take it? Kneeling on my naked right knee, my left forming a square, my right hand on the Holy Bible, square, and compasses, my left arm forming an angle, supported by the square, and my hand in a vertical position. Candidate. I am. Worshipful Master. Then, if you have no objections, you will say, I, and repeat your name after me. Here the Master gives two raps with his gavel, two times, which is the signal for all the brethren to assemble around the altar. Join us next week for the next section of the second or Fellowcraft degree of Freemasonry.